Box. Hey everybody and welcome back to Wizard TCG and to the second, yes, the second episode. The first one was on my German channel. For Legions Realms at War. And perhaps you have seen some English videos on YouTube concerning Legions, and this is a new TCG from Canada. Yes, again a TCG from Canada. There must be something in the water, you know. And first of all, a big thank you to Taylor, the CEO of Future Lore Studios. And he sent me some stuff so I can show it to you here on cam. And yeah, we divided a little bit the cost because it's very expensive to ship to Germany. So we divided the cost. He paid the stuff and I pay for shipping and for import fees and tax and all that shit. And yes, so I have the chance to open up here in Germany Legions Realms at War. What is Legions all about? It's a TCG, so it's a trading card game. You buy boosters and displays, and you can buy starter decks, two-player starters we will have here. And yes, you play on a mat, but it's not necessary to have the mat, but it helps. Let me put it this way. It's a sweet mat. I show it here, and you will see it in the video too, because it's very beautiful. It's a bigger mat, it's bigger than usual game mats, and you have different zones. First of all, you have your warlord. This is your king piece. It's like in chess, when your warlord dies, you lose the game. He starts outside in his own zone. Then you have the realm, or the realm of the veil. It starts as veil. After some turns, it flips into the realm, and then you get an effect that helps you. You got a synergy that starts outside. This is another effect that is there to help you. And you may have a guardian. This guys you don't get in the starter sets, but you can pull them out of boosters. And this guys help you also tank some damage, and also give you a new resource you need for some cards. What else? How to play? You have turns, and you can play warriors, one warrior hardcasting per turn, and you play in one of the five warrior zones in the top row. In the middle row, you have your unified cards. This is spells or enchantment, something like that. And in the last row on the bottom is the fortified cards. Is something like traps, if you know Yu-Gi-Oh or something like that. You play them face down during your turn, and they will resolve during your opponent's turn. And yeah, it's quite fun. Then you have some zones, your deck zone, your discard pile, and so on, where you can play and you can interact with some kind of graveyard. You say it's here at the discard, and yeah. What's there to tell? I think there's not much to tell. It's very cool because of the warlord who's some kind outside of the game, and the slots that are limited, so you cannot have more than five warriors, not more than five fortified cards, and so on and so on. And this is what the game is, makes it a little bit tricky. And the trap cards that you play face down, and they will pop up and flip, and will be a surprise for your opponent. And yeah, this is quite cool. I think it's a cool game. The art is we got the starters. This is the first run hand-drawn old school art. You will see it. And in the boosters there is the more modern art, and you will see. Okay, without further ado, again thanks to Taylor, and we will jump to the table and open up some Legions Realms at War. Let's go. All right, here we are on the beautiful playmat, and we'll take a little flight and I will show you the cool mat. And proudly Canadian, FLS Future Lore Studios Legions Realms at War .ca, check it out. And here we have the logo. Then we have our different zones, the Veil and the Realm, and Warlord, then Synergy and Guardian. Guardian you will not find in the starter decks. Then we have our five warrior zones, and right is our deck zone, and below there is the discard. Then there is eradication zone. In the middle there are 5 spots for unifieds, and then we have 5 spots for fortifieds, what is our traps. And yeah, this is the great playmat, I think. If you have the chance to get one, because it really helps to play the game, because you have the slots. Of course, when you're an experienced player, you will not really need the mat, but first, if you're starting, it helps, it really helps, and it really looks great. And yeah, okay, so what we will do on this channel, first of all, check out, if you want to, my German channel, because there I started, because it's should be a German review, the first German review I think I did, on Realms at War Legions. And yeah, but I've decided to do an English video too, because yeah, not so many people speak German, so I have have the intention to show it to the English speaking community too. And yeah, let's check it out. And what we will do today is open up 2 starters, 2 player starters. And first of all, we got the mythical beasts against the dwarves, and we got the angels against the demons. Yeah, classical one. And I also got you, I showed you in the intro, that these decks are a second time here, but I won't, I will not open this one, because the these ones are the same as in the boxes, so they will go away to the side. And additional to that, we will open the second 12 boosters of the display. If you haven't seen the German video, check it out for the first 12 boosters. Of course, I speak German, but the cards stay still in English, and so you have a chance to see them all. Okay, but first we will open up the 2 player starter sets. Let's start with angels against demons. We will take our little Mr. Cutter and cut the box open. This 2 player starters is starter is perfect for new players, and if you want to start the game with friend, then I highly recommend to get one of these boxes, because there is nearly everything inside you need. There are no guardian cards in there, but I think that's all. The rest is in here, and what you will see, first of all, we check the back, and you see as a card list, it's first edition. And if you mix it up with other cards, you always have the chance, if you keep this, to rebuild the decks. And yeah, as I said, first edition. And to say something to, oh, it's cut up here, I always forget this one. If you have the first edition, we will have a card that says this is the first edition hand drawn arts, and this is a limited print run, and the art is different to the booster art you will see. So here is first of all our learn to play starting rule card, and it's a big card, double-sided. And here we see the cards, for example, card name, legion crest, card rarity, artist, set code number, flavor text, this is here down below, card text, specific game information, card artwork, of course, and card type. This is how the cards look, we will see during our unboxing. And yeah, as I said, the art will differ, and we will open these boosters with the other 12 boosters from the display. But first of all, we start with the decks, with the ready to play decks. As I said, or did I say it in German? I don't know. Your warlord, your synergy, guardian, and veil starts outside the game, and you already have them when you start, because
they are not inside the game. Your warlord is something like the king in chess. When he dies, you lose the game. And the warlord has always a number. Here the DCM number, and this is how much damage he can take. And after that, you will lose the game. Yeah, we see our warlord is Michael the Divine Wrath. It's the warlord, it says in the upper right corner. And then we got our special abilities, our magical attack, our physical attack. And yeah, this is our warlord. He goes straight to his zone up here. And there he stays. But he can also be attacked and can attack, and yeah, this is the centerpiece of your deck and of your game. You have your synergy that will synergize with your warlord, and you may have, it's optional, your guardian to play along, and he tanks some hits for your warlord, but this is optional. There's also a resource. When a card says consume, you have some points on the guardian that will be needed this resource. This is not on the warlord or somewhere else. So if you want to play these cards, you need a guardian, but in the starter there is no guardian, as I said. Yeah, you will get them from the boosters. Okay, we welcome you into the world of Legions, Rams at War trading card game. With these two player battle decks, you have taking the time to indulge in the artwork of yesteryear. Okay. Not yesterday, yesteryear. These first edition decks provide you an opportunity for a one-time limited print run, yeah, in bold letters, of masterfully hand-done pieces of artwork. So, you will see the art really is different. So, here is our Veil. And the Veil always comes with some Veil counters. Usually it's three. And after they have gone, because at the beginning of each turn, during your countdown phase, remove one Veil counter from Veil of Purity. And when they are gone, switch to German. Sorry, when they are gone, you flip the card, and you have the realm. And this realm has an effect. Perhaps for this one is Bestow one holy counter onto all face up angel cards on your side of the field. And if you wonder what these keywords are, you have a chance to find them on your rules card. For example, we want to look up Bestow. Here it is. So this keyword always will always appear to give other cards you have on the field certain advantages. Sometimes it appears as ATK boost attack is, or the case of the Angel Legion is appears in a granting of holy counters. Okay, so you see, if you want to know something, it's not not all the rules are written down there. You can download the rule book, and there will be all rules in there. So here we have the holy counter thing. Bestow one holy counter onto all face-up angel cards on your side of the field. Yeah, great, great. Okay, let's go. We have a synergy card, and as I said, it should synergize with your warlord. It has cooldown counters, and yeah, you have to cool down 5 times before you can use it. Again, search your deck for 2 angel cards with a Bestow keyword ability at their searches to your hand. Then immediately double the holy counters on all angel warriors currently on your side of the field. This is great, but then 5 counters on it, and it has to cool down for 5 rounds. Okay, so then we start. We have unified cards. Remember, unified cards go in the middle of your field, and they are spells and buffs, and you know, like some lightning strikes or something like that, or some kind of, yeah, call it enchantments in Magic that stay active. This will be marked on the card. Yeah, and we start with Kathanael's Land. All right, and you see the art is really, really old school, but I like it, and there are nice details. If you see something like that, he's, for example, an angel stab with a sword in the background, and yeah, ascension to the Seraphine. a unified card. Two times in here. By the way, you can, when you build your deck, you can have commons, uncommons, and normal 3-star rares. You can have 3 copies with the same card, with the same name in your deck. There are higher rarities, 4-stars rares and 5-star rares. For the 4-stars, you have only a chance of having 2 in your deck, and for the 5-star, only 1. So the rarity reduces the number you can run the card in your deck, and this is a really cool mechanic, I think. Okay, let's go. Sanctum of the Seraphim is the next one. Then we have another unified card, Sablo Seraphim Protection, and this one stays active, it says here. Then we have Seraphim Benevolence, hard for a German to pronounce that one. Oh, then we got Cup Shields Favors for the Seraphim. Yeah, see the Holy Ones, Golden Rings like the Pope. Then we have Barakel's Lightning. And you see, Legions is not afraid of bloody art. I love it. Then, yeah, something like this. This art is cool, isn't it? A unified card, Shanziel's Light of the Seraphim. 3 times. Then we have a fortified card. You know, you remember, fortified cards go to your fortified zone, here, down here. And there are some kind of traps, you play them face down during, as long as the card says nothing else, face down during your turn, but they will trigger or will resolve in the opponent's turn. So this is quite cool, I think. And you can have also 5 of them. Yeah, here is a cross, Michael's Proclamation. Looks a little bit like the cross in Indiana Jones. Then we have Angelic Hostility. He's a very angry man. Fortified card. Then we have Dama's Silence. Yeah. This is some kind of equipment card. It's called ARM. And yeah, if you want to know again what the cards are, or the letters, what it is here, attack, ARM. These are armaments. This is something like equipment cards, you can imagine. And they can be attached to some creatures or something like that, to warriors. So it's a fortified card, 3 times in here. You see there's no rarity on the cards in the corner down left, because it's a starter deck. You will often find Bloodborne. Bloodborne means you have to pay 4 in this example from your DCM, from your Warlord. And yeah, when you reach at this, for this example, 75, you will lose the game. So always be careful with that. It's the Great Deeds of Vretir. Yes, sir. Then we have Raziel, Angel of the Seraphim Secrets. Yes, a warrior. This attack, and it's also, also it's life points, hard to speak today. Who are you? Simon, Judge of the Seraphim. Ah, he has a huge hammer. Attack 1. Then we have Tzirachil, Keeper of Seraphim Memories with Wisdom. When this warrior enters play, the controlling player loops at the top 2 cards of their deck and then at 1 to the hand and the other to the bottom of the deck. So you can check out some cards. This is quite nice. Then we have Targa, Angel of Seraphim Song. Yeah. Playing an instrument here. Sweet. Then we have Muriel, Anger, Angel Seraphim of Freedom. 2 attack. Then we got Ruler of the Seraphim Sky, attack 3 vanilla. Then we have Seraphiel, the Seraphim Soul Punisher. Oh, hard to read, man. Attack 4. This looks quite sweet. Shailiel, the Seraphim Champion. Attack 5. You see, they get stronger. And then we have some cards that will be in every starter, I think, because I saw them in the others too. It's a Dismantle. See this one. Unified card. Another Unified Subvert Connection. Scissors. Then we have Second Chance. This is a really cool artwork with this hand coming with a heart out of the grave. Targobon Warrior in your discard pile. Revive the Target Warrior to your side of the field, so it brings the warrior straight to the field, back from the grave. That's great. Another fortified card we get is Pick Up Their Power. Then we have our Rainbow Shield, as I call it. It's a deflect. Then we have the basic turn structure. You have the countdown phase, you have the reinforce phase, the war phase, and the end phase. And here's a QR code. You can scan and check the details of the rules. Then we got a little bit, spoilers for the next one. It's the Ravage Lands we are unboxing right now. Then Beautiful Harvest coming winter 2021, or perhaps a little bit later. Empires of the Rise. On the rise, coming spring 2022. Information you will get on Legion Rams@War.ca for Canada, and check it out so you will you won't miss anything. Okay, this was the first one. The second one are the demons, and so let's check out the demons. And yeah, I really like the old school art, and I really like the new art. As I said, I unboxed some boosters on my German channel, and it really differs, you will see. But I like both kinds of arts, and it's a really cool idea to do the old school arts in a limited edition for the first starters, and then do some modern arts on the regular boosters. It's a cool idea, I think. So here we have Onos Kellis, the Fallen Angel Priestress. Yes, a Fallen Angel's Priestress. Okay, 75 DCM also. And yeah, you also can check out which faction is by the logo here, by the symbol, and by the color. Rot. It's in German, it's rot. So in English, it's red. Red is for the demons. Again, here we got our card that says you got unique art, limited print run, and so on and so on. And then let's go and check it out. Here's our veil. Also, three veil counters going down one every turn, and then it will flip over to the Scorch Realm. And when this is revealed, immediately activate the following effect. Target up to two warriors on the field, take control of the targeted warriors. The targeted warriors become demons in addition to their other legions. This is great because you can, you take the control of these warriors, and this is a cool thing. I liked it in Magic already for many years. It's a cool thing. So, like a kind of control magic. So here's our synergy. As I said, it is to support your Warlord. River of Forever Fire. Yeah. Cooldown 5, so using it, it will take 5 rounds to cool down. Target up to 2 warriors on the field with a current attack of 3 or less. Take control of the targeted warriors. Oh, I love the control aspect is supported here. They become demons in addition to the other legions. Eradicate the targeted warriors at the end of the turn. Okay. That's fair, I think. What is this? Garuda's Hunger. Unified card. What a bizarre art. Okay. I don't really know where is top and where is bottom? I don't know. Here's this. It's here's a face, I think. I think it's upside down. I don't really know. Okay. Then we got Payments Ceremony of the Fallen. Yeah, he is doing a ritual here. And here comes the evil demon. It's a unified card. It stays active. This is what says ACT. And this is three times in here. Then Bodhi's Fallen Hellblade. Yes, unified. Then we have Volak's Document of the Damned. As I said on my German channel, alliteration is in German, it's very often. Let's see what it's in English. So you got DDD or FFF or CCC, something like that. Let's check it out. Yeah, Bloodborne 4, a unified card. It's three times in here. Then we have the Deeper We've Fallen. Okay. Here's a surface, and here is the Abyss. Bloodborne 10. Okay, ooh, this is hard. Remember, your warlord has 75 only. Then we have Rise of the Fallen Angels, unified card. Then we have Semizar's Rally of the Fallen. All right. Three times. Then Kobalt's Last Love. Yeah. Remember that the last love is on you, or something like that. It was in Life of Brian, wasn't it? The Fallen Voice of Damnation, fortified card. Nice old school art. Oh, this one is great. Ooh, this one is great. Yeah. Sacrificed, crucified women. Yes. Great. Moloch's Fallen Abomination. All right. But they stole their nipples. All right. Next fortified card is Fall of the Fallen. All right. Smiling demons. Then we've got Fallen Firewall, fortified card. Ooh, sweet. Nivas Succubus of the Fallen Dreams. All right. Then we have Nikor, Master of the Fallen, Warrior Attack 1. I think we'll see some warriors now that will get stronger. Mammon, Fallen Angel of Greed. Three times. Here we go. Alastor, the Fallen Nemesis. Attack value 2. Quite sweet. Uva, Duke of the Fallen Armies. Attack 3. Warrior. Then we have Under the Sign of the Pentagram, Deimos, Queen of Fallen Sinners. Yes, attack 4. Who are you? Nice pentagram buckle. It's Astaroth. Grand Duke of the Hell Plains. Yeah, warrior with attack 5. And then we will have our usual unified card, Dismantle. Severed Collection, then our Second Chance. Then we have our Fortified, pick up their power, and our Deflect, our basic turn structure, and a little bit of advertisement. Alright, this was the second deck of this two-player starter, but we are not finished at all, because we will do the next starter right now, because we can. All right. Looks quite sweet. Again, you got your card list on the back, first edition print, your site where you can find all the stuff and all the information. And we will open it up. By the way, it's for the age 14 plus, it says. I don't know, I did not play a whole game, just one or two turns, but I think it can be very interesting. If you got all cards on your, or many cards on your field, all slots are full, and looks sweet. Here again, I think it should hold the two decks, but it's a little too high, but no additional plastic, what is really, really nice. our two decks, our two boosters, and our learn to start, learn to play starting card, rule card. Oh yeah. So I hate the light. Did you hear it? So we will start with the dwarves. All right, let's go. Let's start with the dwarves. Here we go. Here we go. And yeah. So this will do. Yeah, it's gone. And let's check out the dwarves. We see a wonderful foil dwarf. It's our warlord. He got 70 DCM. It's Quartzheart, the Arcane Rune Master. Alright. Alright. The art is sweet. Looks like a cartoon or something, or anime like this. Really cool hand drawn. I love it. Sweet, okay. Let's go. We got our card that says limited front run and so on and so on. And here we go. And we'll check out our veil. Again, three veil counters. I wonder if there are different numbers in, or there will be different numbers in the future. And yeah, we turn it and flip it over to Frost Realm. When this card is revealed, immediately activate the following effect. You can target up to two cards in the on the field. Return the targeted cards to their respective owner's hand. Ah, yeah. It's, yeah. It's the typical blue effect. Cards back to the hand, to their owner. And let's see if the dwarves play like a blue control deck. Let's see. Here's our synergy. Cooldown 5 again. Target X dwarf unified cards in your discard pile and eradicate the targeted cards. Beast or plus X attack up to 3 dwarf warriors you control until the end of your turn, where X was the number of unified cards eradicated by this effect. Okay. Quite sweet. Then, yeah, got a mine. Dwarf dynamite determination. All right, cool art, love it. Then we have Keltor's explosive kit. Yeah, it's a time bomb, I think, something like this. Bloodborne 6, okay. Then, ooh, there you can get rich. I think working there is a very good deal. Mining for minerals. Yeah, there is plenty of them. Unified card. Then we have Into the Collapsed Mine. I don't know if this is a good idea. Unified card. See, the wood is breaking. No good idea, I think. Then we have Blast Forge, Blast Forward. Okay. Unified stays active. Then we have, this is quite cool art. Yeah, the background and the front is really, really different. So yeah, it looks really cool. Unified card, Into the Blast Forge, another active card. Then Nisti's War Cleaver, unified card, Bloodborne 6. Then we have Diary of a Blast Forge Survivor. All right, the Diary of the Survivor for Bloodborne 4. Okay. Then we have Blast Back from the Blast Forge. Yeah, the names are really, really cool sometimes. Unified card. Then we have Boragris Dreamscape. It's what's in his thoughts, I think. Sleeping in a mine, perhaps. Hey, continues to carve out this dreamscape of this. I don't know how he's always asleep. Yes, he is really sleeping. At work. Ooh, we got Redoka's Prayer Gauntlet. Sweet, fortified. Bloodborne 2. Then we got Blast Forge Blast Shield. Fire Dragon here, fortified card. Three times. Then we got Gila, the Blast Forge Inspector. Yeah, the Blast Forge Inspector Warrior, attack 1. Then we have Dalgo, Blastforge, Tunnel Digger. Yeah, with a sweet tool. Attack one. Then we have Stolara, the Blastforge Apprentice, a female dwarf. Attack one also. Then we have Hinala, Blastforge Sapphire Breaker, Vanilla Warrior for two attack, or with two attack. Then we got Ozzyk, Blastforge Bludgeoneer. Oh, alright. Vanilla Warrior attack three. Then we have Runehelm, the Blastforge Wizard. Yes, sir. Warrior attack four. And we got Quidex, Blastforge, Honorbringer, Warrior attack 5. I think now will come our Dismantle, our Severed Connection, our Second Chance, pick up the power, our Rainbow Shield deflect, and some basic turn structure, and some advertisement. Alright, also cool arts, I really like this ones. Especially, I think, where it is this one. I like the contrast of the background and the front. This is really cool. I like old school art. Yeah, I really do. Okay, let's go here. And let's open up the Mythical Beasts. And yeah, let's see what we'll get here. Yeah, by the way, do you know, or did you know this game before? And what do you think of this game so far? There are some English videos on YouTube right now, and one or two Let's Plays. And I think it's a really fun game. It looks really good. So, here's a Warlord with 80 DCM. I think this is the highest number of DCM I've seen so far. It's Schlara, the Mythic Fire Phoenix. Ooh, sweet, 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 sweet. Cooldown 4 turns, Bloodborne 10. Alright. Sweet, sweet. Looks great, looks great. Okay. Then we have our card again here, our Veil. It's Veil of Enchantment. Three Veil counters, we flip it. And, oh, it's the Rainbow Land Magical Realm. Or a realm, sorry. stupid German. Following effect. Search your deck for one mythical beast unified card. One mythical beast fortified card. Add both cards to your hand. Okay, to your hand is sweet, but to the battlefield is always better, in my opinion. But yeah, quite sweet. Okay, then we have our synergy. Cooldown 5, target up to 2 Mythical Beasts unified and or fortified cards for a discard pile. Shuffle the target cards back into your deck. Okay, back into your deck. Target 2 Mythical Beasts warriors in your discard pile. Add the targeted cards to your hand. Oh, this is sweet. This is sweet, okay. Then we have a unicorn. It's an angry unicorn. And, yeah. Okay. Sparking Burst Energy unified card. Sweet. Ooh, this is quite nice. The flower sprouts from the mystic fire ashes. Alright. Right, right. Once per turn you can pace Bloodborne 6, okay. Ooh, awakening the mystic fire. Alright. Flame of Mystic Fire Origin. You see, the art is really, really old school, but I like it. Who are you? Shara's Blazing Fire. This looks like an evil chicken. You remember Terminator 2? Where it walks through the fire? It's the Terminator chicken. Alright, Dragon Arrowling's Fang. A unified card. Then we got Mystic Fire, Magic Blessing. The blessing starts at the wings, I think. Then we have Mystic Fire Arena, unified, active card. Then we have Mystic Fire Offspring. Mm-hmm. Alright, alright. Then we got Mystic Fire Boost Flame fortified card. Oh, then we got another fortified card. It's a Vary of the Phoenix Flames. And this is interesting art. Then we got Mystic Fire Burn Cycle. Oh, this is cool. Look here. In the eyes, the reflection of a screaming dwarf, I think it is. Mystic Fire Blaze Rage. Fortified card, active. Three times. Then we got Murph and Case oder Quace. Mystic Fire Eclipse Dragons. Yeah. Interesting color they got. Just looking at this, the first thing came to my mind, sorry, but do you remember the game that came on, I think it was on the PC? After Manic Mansion, Day of the Tentacle. This was my the first picture I got before my eyes looking at this one. It's Izud, the Mystic Fire Sprite, a warrior. Now a warrior starting. Then we got, who are you? Shimmerwing, the Mystic Fire Pegasus. Also attack with attack one with Parish. Then our attack two warrior Solar, the Mystic Fire Flare Fox. Yeah, here we go. Fire Flare Fox. Two times. Then we got Jinx, the Mystic Glimmer Griffon. Yes. Got two of him. Then Mystic Fire Chimera King Karmikin. Warrior 4 attack, Vanilla. And our 5 attack warrior is Ragon, the Great Mystic Fire Dragon. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Alright, then we got our usual cards. Dismantle, Served Collection, Second Chance, Pick Up the Power, Deflect, Your Turns, and a little bit advertisement coming up. Check them out. The new releases of Legions. So, okay, this was the fourth deck, so we got both of the two-player starters opened up. Now we will start with our boosters, right? Alright, so we will take 12 boosters from the display remaining, plus the 4 we got here. And what I learned from my first video, unboxing Legions, it's hard to open the boosters sometimes. Some are really tough glued, and yeah. So I take some scissors and do it like that. I also learned there are 3 or 4 cards in the back that come after the rare. So we check out first the commons, then the uncommons, and then the rare. Perhaps there may be the last card in token, but yeah, I like to have the rare at the end. And okay, so let's check out. You will see now cards you haven't seen on the starters. And yeah, here we got a fortified card. We also see different factions. And yeah, let's go. You also are here. Here we get talking about guardians at the beginning. This is the resource. It's says consume 5, and this consume costs can only be paid by guardians. And yeah, perhaps we will see one here, and then I will show you. So throwing off the balance. Here's a little print line on it. But the art is quite sweet. Then we have enhanced by Hood Magic. Then we have Grim Wish for more life, yeah. Alright. Then we have Cavern of the Careless. Then we have Varkur the Orcbane Weapon Master. I highly recommend to check out the first video, my drum one, where I'm doing the starter with orcs. There are the old school orc artworks are awesome sometimes. Journey through Glacier Pass. Ooh, this is sweet. You see, the art is different from the old school art. It's Hanswick, the daring rook. Yes. And now, speaking of rarity, here we see the focus sucks. Okay, here we see two stars is an uncommon, one star is a rare. We also have, if you want to look it up, just take your smart little sheet or rule card, and this will tell you that you can play three copies of common one star, uncommon two star, and rare three star. Two copies of the same renowned rare, it's four star, it's silver, with a silver swoop, and you can only play one copy of exalted rare. So we have rarities, we have common, uncommon, rare, renowned rare, and exalted rare here. And let's hope that we will see. I've never seen an five star rare. Let's see. Okay, this guy we had. Then we have Fallen Flames Forever Flicker. Here we go. FFFF, alliteration for the win. Another uncommon, and here's a rare. It's a normal rare, three star rare. It's Blastforge Melt Cannon. All right, it's an arm card, so you, some kind of equipment. This card can only be equipped to a Blastforge Dwarf Warrior, it says. Okay, Beastar plus a six attack to the equipped warrior at the end of this turn. This card was equipped. Destroy the equipped warrior. Oh, this is hard. But plus six is great. If this card is in your discard pile, you can target one card on the field and eradicate this card. Destroy the targeted card. Okay. Sweet. And then, as I said, maybe there's a token in the end. It's Phoenix Hatchling. Alright. This is how a booster looks here. And I hope we will see a higher rare. Let's see. Okay, here we go. Quite sweet art. Incarnate Hellhound, and you see the art really differs from the booster packs. Then we have Super Sprite Summoning, 3x S. Then we have Sacred Seraphim Shield, you know what I mean. Then we have Quantum Iron Blastforge Elder Druid, with a cool owl and different colored eyes. Then we have Ravenic Warrior in the Resistance with a cool badass in the back. Oh, what's that? Well, I didn't see this last time. Check out the details. Here's some dead orcs. Orc head lying on the ground, an old axe of orcs. Cool. I like the details sometimes here. Then we got Moonlit Meadows of Mystery, fortified card with consume. Again, you need a guardian for that. Then the old lady, the matriarch of Grim Agony, vanilla attack 4 warrior. And then we have Shattered on the Frozen Anvil, nice. Bloodborne 10, ooh, hard. And our rare is, another uncommon, from the marketplace pleb. All right, now here we go. It's a normal three star, nothing left but putrid plug. Okay, that's not so good, I think. Once per turn, you can pay Bloodborne 4, eradicate one putrid undead card from your hand or from your side of the field face up. Deal 2 damage to all warriors on the field. Once per turn, you can pay Bloodborne 4 and target one undead card in your eradication zone. Send the target card to the discard pile. You can only control one face up. Nothing left but putrid plague. Okay, only one. Sweet. All right. Okay. Let's move on. And 1, 2, 3. And this and that, and turn around, and here we go, starting with Release the Fallen Inner Demon. This card, the name is really cool, isn't it? Then we have Seraphim Call for the Holy Defense. Then one of my favorite arts here for the undead. It's Sleepy by Putrid Puppet of Sickness. Like a puppet on a string, you see? Very cool. Then we have Light Spirit, Light Sprite, Light Sprite of the Ever Bright. Sorry, this is hard. But the art is cool. Then we got Pick Your Putrid Poison. The skeleton left with one eye. Ball. Then, oh, Unstoppable Fury. I think we haven't seen that one. Then we have A Dance with Death. Alright. Then From Open Clouds They Fall. Bloodborne 8. Alright. And our rare is a 3-star again. It's the Grimoire Chapter 2. Yes, this consume 10. Alright. And we got a token Lower Principalities. Alright. Alright, alright, alright. The rarity here is really rare, I think. We haven't seen that much higher rarities than 3-star. Alright, we start next booster. Check out what we'll get. Warrior Statue. It's, some kind of defender, you can say. It's a blockade. He can not attack, but 5, he will tank for you. I haven't mentioned that as long as you get warriors on your field, your opponent will not be able to attack your warlord. This is an important thing to mention, I think. Primordial's release from shells. Here is our sea dragon again. Liquid's the majestic sea dragon. Then we have Lord Baldur Resistance Crusader. Then we have Seraphim's High Blessing. We got Unstoppable Anger. Coming to the uncommons, Blast Forge Armory. Right. Ooh, this is sweet. Fortified card, it's Mystic Fire of the Manticore. Right, sweet. We got an Orc. Godex the Orcbane Torture Tank. What a name. Yeah. Attack 5 Warrior, vanilla. 3-star rare, fortified card. Trap in the Black Powder Room. Once per turn, you can pay Bloodborne 4 and target one warrior on the field. Is attempting to activate a keyword ability. Negate the activation of the target warrior's keyword ability and return the target warrior to the owner's hand. You can only control one face up trap in the Black Powder Room. Alright, okay, this is quite sweet. If there's a card that really sucks and your opponent tries to activate, you play that one and yeah, it will be fine. Alright, next booster. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. A token, it's our Armored Warboar. Then we have this really cool Warhammer 40k look like artwork. It's a Dux Vox Hidden Contraption fortified card. Then we got Never Shake the Cold, another fortified card. Among the Ranks of the Resistance, unified card. Then our sweet Light Sprite. He is Volkur the Orcbane Weapon Master. Attack 4 warrior for the orcs. Then another really cool artwork, I think. Blight the Putrid Bog Being. Check this out. Great. Yeah, attack 5 warrior. Then, we got Galvik Orcbane Body Carver. Yes, man. And we got a Slow But Grim Decay. Nice card names they got here, nice card names. And we got again a 3-star rare Trap in the Black Powder Room. Yeah, I think you know this one. Okay. I think it was the last pack, wasn't it? Last booster we got the same rare. Maybe. So, 1, 2, 3. Turn around. Who are you? Tardian Strings, some Cthulhu looking demon. Something like that, but I think yellow is Titans, or is it demons? No, it's Titans, I think. I think it's Titans, okay. Interesting, interesting. Then we got Replenish Faults. Then we got Stoke the Blast Forge, fortified card. We got an Orc Lady, a well-trained Orc Lady. Oh, a struggling one of their own. Pits of the Outer Rim. Alright, fortified card. Then we have Unstoppable Titan War Siege. Here we go. Who are you? It's Mystic Fire Baby Dragon, Sparkmaw. Sweet. Attack 2 Warrior. Then we got fortified card, Damn Bodies, Fallen Souls. The names are so sweet here. Then we got Mystic Fire from the Golden Urn. Alright. And then we got Jibble, Gifter of the Seraphim, a warrior. And our rare is a 3-star again, it's a Divine Denial of the Seraphim. When this card first activated, you can bestow one holy counter on to all other face-up Seraphim Angel cards on your side on the field. Once per turn, you can remove 6 holy counters from your side of the field and target one face-up unified card on the field, negate the activation or effect, destroy the targeted card. Alright. Und wir können, and we can, again German, and we can only have one face-up of this card. Yes, sir. Right, next one, please. And yeah, if you enjoy what I'm doing and having so much fun as I do, yeah, just leave a like, subscribe, comment down below this video, or just check out my other videos, or support me on Patreon. That would be very, very nice of you. So, okay, let's go. Here's again our Cthulhu buddy. I think we did not see this one. Patricia Putrid, the Vile Bile Princess. All right. Perish target warrior. Target one warrior on each player's side of the field. Deal 3 damage to all target warriors. Sweet. Nice art. Ooh. Amshadow's Isles. This is sweet. A place to be now. Here it's stormy and it's raining and this looks sweet. Alright, dragged into the Hell Plains. This is not so sweet. Mort Soul Revival. Consume 10, okay. Then we got Monitoys? Monitoys? Monitious? Primordial Doomed Might. Then we got Stoga Frost Blastforge Flamekeeper. Warrior. Then we got Decay of Evermore. Target X under cards in your discard pile. Eradicate the targeted cards. Deal X damage to all warriors on the target player's side of the field, where X is the amount of undead cards you eradicate by this effect. I love these reanimator stuff. Then we got Fallen Soul Harvester Shade. This is cool. Look at this one. It's divided, the card, by the text box. Looks really cool. Okay. And we got a normal 3-star again. Walking Through Fire. Consume 10, discard one card from your hand, target one demon warrior on the field of a targeted warrior against both of the following effects. Perish, your opponent discards 2 cards. Perish, draw 2 cards. Alright. Quite sweet, I think. Quite sweet. Of course you will check out the cards or really see what they do when you play them on the field, person against person, but sounds quite good. Incarnate Hellhound, we know that guy. Release the Fallen Inner Demon, I like the title. Then Seraphim Call for the Holy Defense, we know. Then we have the Hood Become the Resistance, yes, unified card. Then we have Vanderheim, the Alehouse Drunkard. Yeah. Looks like he's off there and drinking some ale. Ruin the Caven Supplier. Looks a little bit vicious. Then Primordial Child of Justice, Themis. Warrior Attack 5. Then release the Spirit Horde. Alright, Bloodborne 5, Consume 5. Then we have Duxworks Underground Workshop. Yeah, working on an some mechanical hand. All right, sweet. And we got another 3-star Phoenix Flames Conflagration. This card also is treated as a Mystic Fire card while face up on the field. All Phoenix Hatchling on your side of the field are also treated as Mystic Fire Mythical Beast Warriors. Once per turn, you can discard one Phoenix Flames card from your hand, Beast Star plus one attack to all Mystic Fire Mythical Beast Warriors on your side of the field until the end of turn. You can only control one face up Phoenix Flames configuration. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. So, something for our Phoenix creatures and tokens. So, next one. Here we go. So, again, our puppet. Quite sweet. Then we got Sacrificial Throne of the Hell Plains. Oh yeah, that's evil. Then we got Feathers in the Wind, Furified card. Then we have Sacred Savannah. This is well drawn. This looks just like a picture. Sweet. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Shroud of the Black Magic. Look at the eyes glooming there in the fog. Sweet. Then Forbidden Fjords. It's going up to Norway. Then Battle Charge Blitz. Unified card. Then we got Blast Forge Armory. And here we go, 4-star Fields of Floating. Here's a synergy, and really great that I can show you a 4-star. So you see the foiling is quite sweet, the frame is also foiled. You see the swoop is silver, I hope you see. Yes, there. Okay, cool down 6. Target up to 500 cards in your discard pile. Eradicate the target cards. Then, if you do, you can manifest up to X Shambling Skeleton Undead Warrior tokens attack 2 to your side of the battlefield, where X is the amount of undead cards you eradicate by this effect. At the end of turn, add all cards eradicated by this effect to your hand. This is a cool synergy and a cool looking card. Great, 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 great. I'm very happy you got this. And we will have a token right behind it. Yes, it's a Frost Wolf. Sweet, sweet. I'm happy to get this one, because as I said, the first deck I will play will be the undead ones. And yeah, surprise, surprise. Let's go. Warrior Statue, defender. Then Titan's Tumble, unified card. Who are you? Zinvox Duxvox Medic. Oh, it's a doctor. Holy shit. Look at his face. No, I don't want to be there. No. No way. Recover 3. When this warrior enters play, the controlling player can choose to reduce the damage counter max DCM of their warlord by the recover number. Okay. Yeah, it looks crazy, but he helps. Yeah, he helps. Is he get vaccinated? All right, quite cool. 3 damage down. Okay, Alehouse Secret Supply Entrance. You get the good stuff going down there. Light of the Real Truth. Okay, interesting art. Then we got another interesting art, Franz, or in German we say Franz, the Blast Forge Geysir Blaster. Alright. Then again, Mystic Fire of the Manticore, sweet art. Then we got Gardex, the Orcbane Torture Tank, yeah, or a 5 attack warrior. Then we have Unstoppable Fury, unified card. And we get another 3-star, but I don't know this one. This is Fandorian Flail of Castle Thornhaven. Okay, Bloodborne 5. This card equips to a hero. It's an arm card, okay. Equips to a hero warrior you control. Beastow plus 1 attack to the equipped warrior, and the warrior gains Retilate. When this warrior battles another warrior, this warrior deals damage to the opponent's warlord equal to the damage this warrior took during battle. This is quite a sweet effect, I think. If this card is equipped to Fandorian Hero Warrior, bestow plus for attack and retaliate instead. Okay. Sweet. Quite cool card, I think. But mainly I'm looking for some undead cards for my undead deck. And 1, 2, 3. Let's go. Here it's again our Armored Warbar, the token. Then we have Escape from the Explosion Mountain. Yeah. The donkey is afraid, I think. And the dwarf is crazy because I think he did this. Then we got Fallen Brimstone Sky. Alright, fortified card. Active. Oh, we got a nice little lady. Eos, Primordial Child of Arion. Hello. What? It's a flower in the hand, isn't it? Yes, I think. Some Greek buildings. Ooh, Malady's Putrid Burial Ground. Yeah, sweet. Then we have Blastforge Extreme. Yeah, this looks extreme. Then we got Scarling Fingers Peak. Okay. Ooh, sweet. Unstoppable Power Bond. Oh, what is he doing there? Strategy room below the alehouse. Okay. Strategy room below the alehouse. This is an interesting place for a strategic room. And we got another 3-star Black Magic Hellfire. Alright, unified card, Bloodborne 10, consume 10, alright. Target 5 Black Magic Demon cards in your discard pile. And target up to 5 non-demon cards in the on the field, eradicate the targeted cards. If this card is eradicated by the effect of Black Magic Demon, deal 2 damage to all warriors on target player's side of the field. You can only activate either effect Black Magic Hellfire once per turn. Interesting. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 boosters left only. Then I think I have a hard time to get my hands on stuff of Legion for the next time because it's hard to import it here in Germany. So, among the ranks of the resistance, I would love to open more of this stuff, I must say. Grim Outlook of the Afterlife. Look in the mirror. This is great. Here is the lady and here's the skeleton lady. Fortified card, sweet. Then, ooh, looks like the... I've lost the name, but... this is cool art with the background, the demon or something. The water spirit is water sprite. No, sprite was the other one of Everflow Cascades. This looks cool. Then we got Gamble with Life. Then we have Orcbane Salvage Wagon, fortified card. Then we got Hidden Hands of the Hood. We got Narkia Angel from the Chaos Divine, the Parish. We got Gojin Vox, Dux Vox Diehard with Plunder. And we got a 3-star, it's the Lance of the Lost Messiah, Consume 50. You can only activate this card if you have 30 or more holy counters on your side of the field. Okay, what's it? On earth it's doing. Deal 20 damage to target player's warlord. You can only activate one lance of Lostifier per turn. 20 damage to target player's warlord. Okay, consume 50 is hard. 30 counters, I think it's also hard. But 20 damage is really, really, really sweet. Okay, we got the Shambling Skeleton token for our undead deck. This is also good. 20 damage to warlord. Okay, okay, okay. Why not? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. So here we have Cassador North Battalion Monifex. Alright. Ooh, this is sweet. Elemental Sprite Gathering. Nice colors. Then we have. Ooh, yeah. Sweet. As I said, undead, always the best. Petrella, the Putrid Groundskeeper. Alright. Then we have Grim Nightmare. Alright. Here we go. Then we have Hope for a New Day. Harsh contrast to the last two cards, but also great. Again, a Dance with Death. From Open Clouds, they fall. Mystic Fire Beast Power. Another 3-star rare, Return of the Primordials. You can only activate this card if your Titan Warlord is Prometheus, the Eternal Spirit, and the damage counter max DCM of your Titan Warlord is 45 or more. Ah, okay. Eradicate the top 4 cards of your deck face up, then reduce the damage counter DCM of your Titan Warlord by X plus 1, where X is the amount of Titan cards that are in your player's eradication zones. And we can only activate Return of the Primordials once per turn. Alright, then we got a token, Lower Principalities, and okay. Interesting card. So, last 3 boosters, everybody. Here we go. Come on. Saw that one. Turn around. So, Hope for a New Day again. Then, Frigid, the Unstoppable Glacier. Alright. Then, Throwing off the Balance. Hope for Another Day. Eos, the Nice Lady again. Then we got Falling Phoenix Flames. Fortified card. Primordials answer to call. Answer the call, okay, not two. Then For the Love of the Hunt. Alright. Sweet. And another 3-star, Rebirth in Phoenix Flames. Bloodborne 10. You can only play this card if your mythical beast warlord is Shilara, the Mystic Fire Phoenix. Manifest up to 5 Phoenix Hatchling Mythical Beast Warrior tokens, attack 2 to your side of the field. If you control face up Averia of the Phoenix Flames when you activate this card, you can also search your deck for 1 Phoenix Flames unified card and add it to your hand. Yeah, a really cool card for Phoenix deck. Yeah, multiple effects. Sweet. And another Frost Wolf token. So, 2 boosters left. One, two, three. Again, our defender. Blockade, it's warrior statue. Then we have Enhanced by Hood Magic. Grimwish for More Life. Milady's Putrid Burial Ground. Blast Forge Extreme. Gamble with life. Ooh, who are you? Sweet art. Great. Armageddon, Horseman of the Fallen. Yes, sir. Scorching Phoenix Flames. Then Sirgrim Crimson, the Undead Prince. Okay, I thought it was a female. Sorry for that one. And another 3-star. The Grand Ale House. Yeah, it's where all the magic begins. Drinking some ale. Once per turn, you can place one ale counter on this card. Once per turn, you can remove 2 ale counters from this card and target 1 warrior on the field. Place the targeted warrior on the top of its owner's deck. If this face-up card is destroyed by a card effect, search your deck for 1 ale house card for every 2 ale counters on this card when it was destroyed. Okay, Rum and Skull, it warms our soul. As the weather looks fierce outside, come for a drink, no matter you stink, for we're all just along for the ride. Dwarf drinking song. Great. Nice flavor text. And here we go, last booster, ladies and gentlemen, for my XXL unboxing. Okay, let's turn it around. Unified card, Super Sprite Summoning. We got Sacred Seraphim Shield. The Primordials Enter the Fray. Also great art. Look at the details. Then we have Orcbane Salvage Wagon again. We have Pyro Lights of the Fallen. Yeah, quite sweet. Then we have Training Grounds of the Primordials. We've got Jester of Black Magic. This looks cool. What is Jester's cap? Then we got Rise of Forgotten Resistance. And the last one is a 3-star rare, Forever Unstoppable. Once per turn you can eradicate one unstoppable card from your hand face up, then draw one card. Once per turn you can pay Bloodborne 8 and target one unstoppable card in your eradication zone and one warrior on the field. Add the targeted unstoppable card to your hand and then destroy the targeted warrior on the field. You can only control one face up forever unstoppable. Alright, then we got a token, draw principalities, and then we're done. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this was my second opening Legion's Realms at War. And alright, let's sum up my thoughts on this one. This was the first time I got in touch with Legions, and it looks quite sweet. The art is interesting. It starts on the starters with this one, and comes out on the boosters with sweet things like this one. And I love both, and I love the idea of the play, and I love the mechanics I found out so far, and I love the idea that cards start outside of the game and stay there, and you have one central unit. What is your warlord that must be destroyed, but is protected by other things, by your warriors, for example, or something like that. The guardian that has an own resource you can only have with guardians. This is also cool, but I think in the German unboxing I get one guardian only, so this is something I cannot play at this time. Really sad, but okay. It's also cool that you have a limited number of slots where you can play cards. It's great that you have traps, something like that, for your enemy, and you play them face down. This is also a great thing. You have different zones. You have interaction with your it's not called graveyard here, with your discard pile, you can say. And so after all, and after this short look, I think it's a good game, and it's worth checking out and playing it. And so do this and check out Legions Realms at War .ca. Check out your local game store. I highly recommend to get one of these great playmats, and then you can grab a 2-player starter or something like that, or I think it will be the best way to start. You get 2 decks, you get a rules card, you can print out your comprehensive rulebook, and then you're ready to play, I think. And this is how it has to be. This is, I think, a really, really nice game. Okay, first of all, before I say goodbye, big thanks to Taylor, who sent me that stuff. And as I said in the beginning, we shared the course. He paid the cards, and I paid for importing them to Germany and shipping. And I think it was in the end it was 50-50 because it's not nice what we pay here to import just some cards here in Germany. It's not nice. Okay, yeah, as I said, thanks again. I'd love to open more of Legions if there's a way we can deal again, and perhaps with a new edition, or when you ship some boxes of the Ravaged Lands to Germany, just let me know, and perhaps we can do another video and check out new cards for Legions. Alright, I'm very excited to see what's coming up for this game, and I'm really excited how the new cards and the new mechanics will work. I love the playmat, thanks for that again. And let's get going, and you start with Legions if you want to. And just grab a 2-player starter and go. Okay, this was my second video and my first on Wizard TCG for Legions, Rams at War. Check out my German channel, Weekend Wizard Analog Games channel. And there you'll find the first 12 boosters and the other two starters of Legions, Rams at War. And it was a ton of fun to open these cards. And you see, the video is quite long and the other is also quite long. But yeah. For Taylor sending me this, I think it was worth to invest some time and check out all these great cards. Alright, that's all. As I said, if you want to support me, just like, subscribe. If you want to support me even more, just check out my Patreon account. I'm happy for every amount of money, so I can import, for example, cards for this game or something else. And yeah, I'm really interested what you think about Legions, so put a comment down below and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching, thanks for your attention, have a good one, bye bye.